It's Beer O'Clock on Real Ale Craft Beer. Today we're going to be taking a look at a beer that's been brewed out of a red light district. The red light district being in Hamburg in Germany. It's known as the Reeperbahn. And a lot of you would have heard of the brand Holsten, Holsten Pils. Back in the 1990s, Jurgen Klinsmann, Tottenham Hotspur, Holsten across the top of the front, the top of the football shirt, yeah, is a big advert. They were a massive, massive company. Not anymore, really. What I understand, so where we are here in Germany, in Hamburg, Holsten is from Hamburg, and it's just not doing very well. It's just not doing very well as a company anymore. But, very cleverly, they own this Astra brand. And the Astra brewery is based in the middle of the red light district in Hamburg, in Germany, in the Reeperbahn. In fact, this beer is called Rotlight, which, if you transfer that over to the English language, means red light. And you can see that the heel and... It's unashamedly, they know what they're doing with marketing. They know exactly what they're doing, this company. So expect to see a lot more of this, even in the UK, in the years to come, the Astra brand. So without further ado, let's get the beer out into a glass and see what we get. ABV. Oh, look at this. Look at this. It's not looking very lively at all, this. Blimey. Oh, here we go. This looks a little bit better. This looks really interesting. Now, what I'm picking up is, for some bizarre reason, in a brown bottle, I'm picking up a little bit of skunkiness from the beer. It's a little bit skunky somehow. How have they managed to do that? Brown glass, but I've never had a beer from a brown... I've never had a skunky beer from a brown glass bottle. Normally it's clear or it's green. It's gone. A lot of it's gone now. It's evaporated into the air, but... The initial aroma on the beer was something. It really was. It was like, oof. Like something that comes out the back of a skunk's backside. Hoppy. A little bit of malt coming through. It's not the most interesting beer that we've ever got our kind of noses around here on the channel. It's quite disappointing, to be honest. A little bit of pepperiness, a little bit of spiciness. Let's dive in. Cheers. Oh. Caramel. Caramel, caramel. Toffee, biscuit. Spice, pepperiness, a little bit of tobacco smoke. It's not the best beer. In fact, in my whole time in Germany, in Hamburg, I'm going to say this is the worst beer. I must have drunk. I've been here for 4 days now. We're literally, the Reeperbahn is just the other side of the hotel here. We're right in the district, the Reeperbahn district. I've been here for 4 days in Hamburg in Germany, and I've drunk probably 60 beers. And ironically, before I packed my camera down to put it all in my suitcase and get ready to go home tomorrow. Drinking the last beer, reviewing the last beer, and I might have a beer in the airport, but reviewing the last beer in Germany, in Hamburg in Germany, has been a bit of a wet experience. It's a bit of a bad ending, really, to our experience. It's just not very good. It's just not very good. Let me try and explain why. It's quite tinny. It's quite tinny and metallic. Isn't it funny in life how Holsten Pils, I had a Holsten Pils, you might have seen the video of me on the Hamburg, outside the Hamburg town hall with the river flowing underneath me, and I sat up on the bridge and people were saying hello to me. I reviewed Holsten Pils in Hamburg, 4.8% ABV, and I actually really liked it. I really, really liked it on the bridge. It was a lovely day, thoroughly enjoyed myself, and how come a beer can go down in quality, Holsten Pils, and almost like the brand is disappearing, and then you've got a brand like Astra where the beer is tasting not as good, going up? I don't quite understand that, but hey, that is marketing for you. That is marketing. If you market something correctly, if you market something fantastic, then it's going to work. It really is going to work. It doesn't matter really anymore, does it? It doesn't matter if the beer tastes rubbish. If it's marketed well, then it's going to work. And it just, I think it just shows the state where we're in. The we're driven by the, I'm pointing at a television, by the way, in my hotel room, but we're driven by television, we're driven by marketing, we're driven by these clever companies showing us the way. And showing us the way is never it's never the right way, is it? I much prefer a pint of Holsten Pils over this any day of the week. And it's the same company. So I'm going to rate it. It's just tinny and metallic and cheap tasting. It's a little bit astringent. You can feel a little bit of a burn on the back of the throat. Maybe some sweeteners in there. It's just a not very good beer. And again, ironically, it's the last beer while I have in Germany, in Hamburg in Germany. So for that reason, I'm going to rate it. And I'm going to give it I'm going to give this a 4 out of 10. It's a 4 out of 10 from Real Ale Craft Beer. Please put your comments in the comments box. Subscribe to our daily beer and food reviews. Give us a big fat thumbs up. Boom. Cheers.